I am very happy that all of you have gathered together for the APNA meeting today. And Uncle Joe has come all the way from India to be with you. I am reminded of my last meeting 2 years back when all of us were gathered at Dr. Dinkar's place. I would like to make a short presentation on what has happened during the last year and a half. This is St. Aloysius College campus, a bird's eye view of the whole campus, and I'm very sure you are reminded of your own days here when you studied in the, maybe in the high school or the PUC or, and maybe also in college. This is the institution which has grown so much during the past few years. This is the IT building, and there is already a new block for the PU science. Now this is the corridor of the high school through which thousands and thousands of young boys and now girls have passed through during the last 135 years. So many of you, when you come back, you always tell us that you miss the environment which is there, and what you are today is because of the education you got at St. Aloysius College. We have so many young students these days, more than 12 to 13,000 students at three campuses, the SAC campus, the Beery campus where we offer MBA, MCA and MSc Software Technology, and the Harihar campus, St. Aloysius College, Harihar. This is the high school. I'm very sure you have a lot of fond memories, especially going up the tower on Rector's Day. I'm very sure it was a beautiful experience and a very memorable experience. We have a lot of young students, very talented, and I'm very sure these are going to be the future great persons like you yourself have become. Here, for example, we have these three students, Hrithik, Sumit and Rion. Very sure they are going to be also aeronautic engineers and maybe design special aircrafts in future. They show such an amount of interest. This is one more boy, Chandran, Savin Chandran, who has got Yuva Vijnani Award, doing well. These are other students, Manohar, Nachiket. These took part in international competitions in swimming and karate, and they won medals and prizes for that. These are the other students, and high school has been doing very well. Last year we had 93% results with lot of distinctions, etc. These are some of our students who have to be congratulated for their achievement. The band of the high school also is doing well under the leadership of Father John. Last year before last, Mr. K.V. Kamath, who belongs to the batch of 63, they came, they were together, and at the end of that, he has given a gift of 25 lakhs for the high school, and with that I got one laboratory and classroom, gallery type classroom ready for students. And Arvind Adiga, our alumnus who won the Man Booker Prize in 2008, recently visited St. Aloysius College. He visited the Beery campus and the high school and the Gonzaga school. He was very happy. He said, "Fathers, you are doing such a wonderful work, and I would like to do something more for the institution." And he has instituted seven scholarships in the name of seven persons. And these scholarships are of 10 lakhs each, altogether 70 lakhs he has given. Plus he has given extra money for the new Gonzaga school and the new Jesuit residence which we want to eventually have. The primary school has been doing well. We have a lot of talented young boys and girls, and these are going to be the future leaders of our country, and not only leaders of our country, we want them to be leaders, international leaders. And very good education is being given in the primary school. Recently we had a program, Uncle Joe also attended that program. We honored seven children from Moodbidri, they took the initiative to dig a well for the village, and they said these could be very good models for our young students, and they were honored by the admission of the primary school. So a lot of activities are there for the primary and all the students of various institutions. Gonzaga School. This is the new addition to the number of institutions we have at St. Aloysius College. We started this institution 4 years back, and already students are there in the 8th standard, and we are just waiting for the final approval by CBSE, which has to come within a month or so. We have already planned a new building for this institution, which is already coming up. The first lab has already been placed, and we have really talented young boys and girls. Now this is the new Gonzaga school building. Within 18 months we are going to have ground plus 3 floors of the part of the building, and the rest of the building will be constructed eventually. St. Aloysius College. St. Aloysius College also has been doing very well. As you know, we have not only undergraduate programs, we have 18 postgraduate programs in St. Aloysius College, and it is an autonomous college. We are functioning almost like a university. Very happy to tell you that NAC accreditation third cycle, we got 3.62 out of 4, and we are placed among the best 100 institutions, including universities in India, and I think we are doing very well. Also, there was recently a survey done by the Week magazine, and St. Aloysius College is 22nd as regards the science colleges. That means out of 30 to 35 colleges, we are the 22nd best college in science. The government of India has instituted Kaushal Center, that is Skill Center at St. Aloysius College. We are among the 2 in Karnataka and one among 50 Kaushal centers in the country. The center is helping us. They are already given about 2 crores. More money is expected for the education of these students who are given skill-based certificates, diplomas, and eventually some of them also will get degree certificates. This is the swimming pool. Work is already commenced, and we are hoping to have it ready by April 2016. We have, of course, some problems are there with financing, etc. Therefore, it is slightly delayed. But this is going to be an asset for St. Aloysius College. Not only St. Aloysius College, it's going to be an asset for Mangalore, because this is the only Olympic size pool which is going to be in Mangalore. In July, we had the inauguration of new science research block, where we have most of our postgraduate programs in science. In the basement of this new building, we have a plan for MSc Food Science and Technology. This way students get, they have external infrastructure, and they get very exposure to the day-to-day functioning of industry. UGC also has recognized the college as a community college, and under this we are offering 3 programs on tourism, animation, and retail management. As you remember, 2 years back when I visited United States, we visited many universities. One among them was SUNY, that is State University of New York. Last year we had 2 students from State University of New York who came here and took part in 1 semester program. This year 4 students have already come, and within a month they should be completing 1 semester work at St. Aloysius College. They are very happy about the program we are offering, and we are expecting many more students to come from other institutions. St. Aloysius More than 4,000 students are studying in St. Aloysius PU College, and we are having excellent infrastructure, and very good education is being imparted. And as you see, last year we secured 98.21% overall pass percentage in PUC, and we had many more students joining the PU College last year. St. Aloysius College. This year is the golden jubilee of St. Aloysius Evening College, and it was recently celebrated, And this evening college was started 50 years back to reach out to those men and women who are working and who would not get a chance to attend a regular day college. So this has really helped so many men and women, and they are very grateful for the education which has been imparted in the evening. And when we had the Jubilee celebration, which was on the 12th of March, we had the Minister for Higher Education participating, and he also congratulated us for the wonderful service we have been offering in the college. St. Evening Pew College also reaches out to those boys and girls who are working during the day, maybe in petrol bunks or as persons who are driving autos, etc. They are also very grateful. Most of them, after completing their Pew studies, they also register for degrees in the evening college. The AMIT campus, St Aloysius College at Biri, it was, as you know, inaugurated. We started functioning in 2009, and already so many batches of students have gone out, and we are very happy. Many of them become entrepreneurs. And we had quite a lot of visitors from other universities, from America and other places. Dr. Jim Joseph from Lemoyne University, Dr. Martha from Lemoyne University visited our institution. They interacted with our students. Also, the president of Fairfield University, Father Vaughan Ax, also came and visited. We are trying to see how we can have some of these collaboration with these universities. We'll have to do a little more of spade work to see that it becomes functional. These are the young students, future leaders. I'm very happy they are getting good education, that is management education and IT education. We also had Dr. Gerard Tellis, who came all the way from California to visit Mangalore, and he interacted with our students, and also we organized a program for the executives in Mangalore. Gerard is originally from Mangalore but settled down in Bombay. Now he is in California. Last time when I visited California, I visited him, and he was willing to come and be with us for 2 days. Our business school got 3 national level awards this year. Dewang Mehta Award for Best Academic Input in Information Technology, and DNA Award for Innovative Teaching Methodology. We are very happy, and this is how our education is recognized by people. Our students also have very good placement. This year, Blue Ocean Ventures offered 11.4 lakhs pay package, the highest we have got ever, and most of our MBA and IT students have been placed already. We also have a College of Education where we train future teachers. Is functioning very well. We have had the new building for the College of Education. Infrastructure development. St. Aloysius College has been growing so much, and recently during the last 2 years we have put up so many buildings, and this year we inaugurated the new PU Science Block. We have spent 14.4 crores on this, and the new PG and Research Block, and the swimming pool under construction, which is going to be inaugurated in April. St. Aloysius College, Harihar. When we celebrated the 125th anniversary of St. Aloysius College, we said we should reach out to the Northern Karnataka. With that in mind, we started this St. Aloysius College, Harihar, and we have put up a very good infrastructure there, and quite a lot of students are attending St. Aloysius PU College. This is the decennial year of St. Aloysius PU College, St. Aloysius College, Harihar. I was present for the decennial celebration. St. Aloysius Technical Training Institute. This institute has been offering various courses. We also have collaboration with Hyundai to train young boys in motor mechanic. This institution offers electrical, tailoring, electronics, welding, motor mechanic and air conditioning and refrigeration courses, and they get good employment through campus recruitment. Alumni visits and reunions. I'm very happy to tell you that many of our alumni have been visiting St. Aloysius College. During the past 2 years, we have had many of them coming. I mentioned already about Arvind Adiga, who came and visited the AMIT campus, the high school, and the new Gonzaga school. He was very happy about the work which is being done at St. Aloysius College. And he said he would like to be part of this initiative to train leaders for tomorrow. In 2013, we had the batch of 63. Mr. K.V. Kamath, who is there, was also part of the group. He came along with his wife. And he has given a gift of 25 lakhs towards the swimming pool of St. Aloysius College and 25 lakhs for the AMIT BD campus. We also had the batch of 64. They also contributed towards the high school, rupees 25 lakhs. This year, we had the batch of 72. And prior to that, last year, again, batch of 94. Like quite a lot of our students have been coming. Once in 2 years, we have been organizing this Eminent Aloysian Alumni Awards, an Aloysian conclave. This year, we honored Mr. Tumbe Moidin from Dubai, Dr. Ullas Karanth, Mr. Walter D'Souza, Dr. K.P. Rao, and Professor B.S. Raman. The program went on very well, and many people participated in this awards function. St. Aloysius College also has the community radio, Sarang. And with this radio, we have been able to reach out to the villages around. And it's a unique radio because I think the whole of the country is the only radio which has programs round the clock for in many languages like Tulu, Konkani, Kannada, Bari language and Malayalam. And people have been interacting with the DJs of this community radio. St. Aloysius Boys Home, you know, it is the centenary gift and it has been going on very well. Father Leo D'Souza, who is in his 80s, still managing to look after the development of these young boys who come to us. Right at the moment, we have over 50 kids are there, and maybe eventually we will have more students joining this year. And Arvind Adiga also has given 35 lakhs for the higher education of these children. Things are going on very well. This year and last year, we organized this Christmas gathering for prominent persons. We found the need of this, reaching out to prominent people like the DC and the Vice Chancellor and the other people. Response was very good, and we had this Christmas program in the month of December this year. There was also a need to have an advisory committee. Last time when I met you, you also spoke, why don't you have an institutional advisory committee? And we took it seriously. On the 5th of March, we had the first meeting of the institutional advisory committee. As you see, we have Mr. Eugene Rent, Mr. Ananta Krishna, former MD of Karnataka Bank, Ms. Meera Aranna, Dr. Derek Lobo, Captain J.P. Menezes, and Michael D'Souza from Dubai, and Mr. Ivan Fernandez, again, our alumnus. All these are along with some of our Jesuits, part of this advisory committee. And they gave very good suggestions. And we will be having at least twice a year, we would like to meet and share what is happening at St. Aloysius College. We also found the need of a finance advisory committee. So here we have Mr. G.C. Pinto, former GM of Corporation Bank, Mr. Lionel Aranna, our chartered accountant, Mr. Alan Pereira, former chairman of Bank of Maharashtra, and Mr. Gerard Colasso, investment advisor. We had the first meeting on the 24th of February, and this will help us also in helping us to how to invest our funds well and how to manage our funds well. Projects planned. As you see, I already spoke about the Gonzaga School. His estimate is about 17 crores. We are going to have the first phase. Maybe we are going to spend around 9 crores immediately to put up ground plus 3 floors of this building. Within 18 months, the 3 floors should be ready for occupation. This is the Students and MDP Center at AMIT Biri. Work has already begun. This also should be ready within the next 18 months. And we are going to spend about 9 crores to put up this building. My great dream is to have a new Jesuit residence. We would like to vacate the old high school building for the St. Aloysius University, where the vice chancellor and the examination section could occupy the residence of Jesuits. Therefore, we want to have a separate building which is going to come up where the red building is there, and we are having the same architecture also for this Jesuit residence, and the estimated cost is around 7. Financial status of Mangalore Jesuit Educational Society. I'm very happy to present to you the surplus deficit of some of the units of Mangalore Jesuit Educational Society. As you see in this table, the St. Aloysius PU College, St. Aloysius Degree College and the AMIT campus have been doing fairly well. Though, if you compare the last two columns for 13, 14 and 14, 15, there seems to be a little downward slide there. But the things are not too bad. But when you consider St. Aloysius Evening College, Technical Institute and Institute of Education, we are having deficit there, and therefore the other institutions here have to support ongoing expenditure of the other institutions. Here you have a comparative analysis of student strength for the last 5 years. As you see, there seems to be during the last 2 years, the decrease in number of students in primary school, high school, evening PUC, evening college, also the degree college in Harihar. Numbers seem to be going down. Here you get a comparative analysis of staff strength for the last 3 years. And as you see, also their salaries. As you see in the 13-14, the total amount spent was only 13.5 crores. It went up to 15.4 crores in 14-15, and it has gone up to 19.2 crores in 15-16. Here you have the capital expenditure of some of the projects completed and some of the ongoing projects. We completed the science block in the month of July, and as you see, budgeted was 12 crores, and we have spent 14.7 crores on the PU science block. The Xavier block budgeted was 10.5 crores and we have spent 11.2 crores on the Xavier block. Now the swimming pool project is still going on. It will be completed, I hope, by April. Budgeted was 6.25, really is much less than that. We budgeted only 4 crores, but already we have spent 4.6, and I'm very sure at least bills will come for 2 more crores for the completion of this pool. St. Aloysius College also has been giving quite a lot of concessions and financial aid to students in various institutions. Here you get an overall picture of the concessions and fee scholarships which have been given, almost amounting to 80 crores. This really doesn't give you the full picture because we are spending much more than 80 crores. More than 1.5 crores are spent in many other ways, like supporting Aloysian Boys Home, and then midday meals and various other programs. So it is much more than 80 lakhs. But we are happy that we are giving, students are benefiting from the institution and getting opportunity to study at St. Aloysius College and high school and all the other institutions. I want all of you to join APNA USA WhatsApp group. I have started that. There are already a few members. Praveen and Tony, kindly see that all members present there are part of this WhatsApp group. I can really interact with you on daily basis and send you information of what is happening. We also, you remember last time when we met, we said we need to have an alumni web portal. It is ready and people have registered. I want as many of our alumni to go to this portal. You have got the URL there. Kindly go and leave information about you there so that many more people know who you are, where you are, etc. Thank you very much. I'm very happy that I have this opportunity to interact with you and say something about the programs at St. Aloysius College and various institutions. And I'm also completing my term as rector. 3 years are over. On the 30th, I'm laying down the office and going back to AMIT campus. 3 years have been beautiful. So much encouragement I've got. Yeah, even I have grown so much as the rector of St. Aloysius College. Thank you very much for your support, and I'm looking forward to interacting with you very soon. Thank you very much. God bless you all.